You know, religious people have such beautiful music and art, and atheists really have nothing. Until now.
This
is the entire atheist hymnal right here. Little tune called Atheists Don't Have No Songs.
Christians have, their hymns and pages.
Hymns and pages.
Habaneguilas for the Jews.
For the Jews.
Baptists have the Rock of Ages.
Rock of Ages.
Atheists just sing the blues.
Romantics play.
Romantics play Clair de Lune.
Clair de Lune.
Born again, sing He is risen. But no one ever wrote a tune.
Wrote a tune.
For godless existentialism.
For atheists,
there's no good news.
They'll never sing
a song of faith.
In their songs,
they have a rule.
The He is always lowercase. The He is always lowercase.
Some folks sing
a Bach cantata.
Bach cantata.
Lutherans get Christmas trees. Atheist songs add up to nada.
Up to nada.
But they do have Sundays free.
Have Sundays free.
Pentecostals sing to heaven.
Sing to heaven.
Coptics had the Book of Scrolls. Numerologists count to seven.
Count to seven.
Atheists have rock and roll.
For atheists,
there's no good news.
They'll never sing
a song of faith.
In their songs,
they have a rule.
The He is always lowercase. The He is always lowercase.
Atheist.
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 Don't have no songs.
Christians have their hymns and pages.
Hymns and pages.
Habaneguilas for the Jews.
For the Jews.
Baptists have the Rock of Ages.
Rock of Ages.
Atheists just sing the blues.
Catholics
dress up for Mass
and listen to
Gregorian chants.
Atheists
just take a pass.
Watch football in their underpants. Watch football in their underpants.
Atheist.
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 Don't have no songs.
Don't have no songs.
Thank you very much.
Let's talk a little bit about the race, Alex, in your home state of North Carolina. Elizabeth Dole, the incumbent Republican, facing a very stiff challenge from Kay Hagan. Listen to this ad that the Dole campaign has now released.
The already bitter battle in the race between Elizabeth Dole and Kay Hagan took another nasty turn today after a controversial attack ad hit the airwaves. Good evening. Hagan is so outraged, she's asking Dole to take it off the air. It deals with politics, religion, and, at least according to the Hagan campaign, whether Hagan believes in God. Here's a look at part of the ad.
No politics, not for the faint of heart, especially in the final days of a tight race. And amid all the attack ads out there on the airwaves right now, competing to out-ugly one another, we think we have found a winner.
I'm Elizabeth Dole, and I approved this message.
A leader of the Godless Americans PAC recently held a secret fundraiser in Kay Hagan's honor.
There is no God to rely on. There was no Jesus.
Taken under God out of the Pledge of Allegiance, you're down with that.
We're down with that.
And in God we trust, you're going to whip that off the money?
Yeah, we would.
Godless Americans and Kay Hagan. She hid from cameras, took godless money. What did Hagan promise in return?
There is no God.
Yeah, you heard that right. There is no God. The only problem is Kay Hagan never said that. Never. Just a picture of her face over someone else's audio. Kay Hagan is a member of the Presbyterian Church. She is a former Sunday school teacher. The fundraiser the ad mentions was not hosted by the Godless American Political Action Committee. A member was one of 40 different co-hosts. Senator John Kerry was at this fundraiser. The information in this ad is so ridiculously misleading, and yet Senator Dole is standing by it and continuing to raise questions about Hagan's so-called godlessness on the campaign trail.
I'm Kay Hagan, and Elizabeth Dole's attacks on my Christian faith are offensive. She even faked my voice in her TV ad to make you think I don't believe in God. Well, I believe in God. I taught Sunday school. My faith guides my life, and Senator Dole knows it. Sure, politics is a tough business, but I approve this message because my campaign is about creating jobs and fixing our economy, not bearing false witness against fellow Christians.
And will you faithfully discharge the duties of your office as mayor of the city of Asheville? So help you God.
I will.
And will you faithfully discharge the duties of your office as a council member of the city of Asheville? So help you God.
I will.
And will you faithfully discharge the duties of your office as a council member of the city of Asheville? Is that your solemn affirmation?
It is.
Your solemn affirmation. That's what you can say instead of, so help me God, if you're swearing to do something, but the fear of needing God's help if you blow it, so help me God, doesn't apply to you. If you do not believe in God, you can give your solemn affirmation instead of saying, so help me God. Last week in Asheville, North Carolina, the fact that one new city councilor was sworn in with a solemn affirmation instead of a so help me God so enraged his critics that they are now threatening to try to remove him from office because he's an atheist. Which is remarkable enough that any American would call someone else unfit for public office purely on the basis of their faith or lack thereof. What's all the more remarkable about this case is that the critics of Asheville, North Carolina City Councilor Cecil Bothwell, those critics sort of have a point, or at least they have a legal reference point. Article 6 of the North Carolina State Constitution includes a list of things that disqualify a person from public office in the state. Things like being convicted of treason, having committed a felony, being impeached from some other office, and then it says right there in Article 6, Section 8, the following person shall be disqualified for office. First, any person who shall deny the being of Almighty God. Yeah, it is actually in the North Carolina state constitution that you're not allowed to hold office if you don't believe in God. And it turns out there are 6 other states that have similar provisions in their constitutions, mandating that office holders have a belief in a supreme being. Maybe you live in one of these states, Arkansas, Maryland, South Carolina, Tennessee, Texas, Mississippi, and the aforementioned North Carolina. All make it illegal to hold public office while being an atheist. Despite the fact that another Article 6 in another constitution, the U.S. Constitution, quite famously says that no religious test shall ever be required as a qualification to any office or public trust under the United States. There's also the very handy Supremacy Clause, which basically says that when there's a conflict between a state constitution and the U.S. Constitution, the U.S. Constitution wins. That's the whole united part in the United States. Still, though, back in Asheville, North Carolina, a local conservative newspaper editor and a local Southern Heritage activist say that the North Carolina atheist ban should be enough to force Cecil Bothwell from his seat on the city council. Mr. Bothwell, of course, has the U.S. Constitution and the whole American idea of religious liberty on his side. The question is how a state is allowed to be officially in writing on the other side.